I'm living with a condition called fibromyalgia. It affects all the muscles, tendons, nerve endings, bones, throughout your body, head to foot. It can feel like you're on fire. It can feel like you've got ants crawling up your skin. You don't just feel one pain in one area. You could have the stabbing in your shoulder blades. You could have the numbness in your legs. You could have the bruised feeling in your arms, and all of this happens at the same time. I was diagnosed in 2012. It was probably last year that I finally accepted that this is how my life is going to be. It's a photo that went around on Facebook saying if fibromyalgia was visible, this is what it would look like. And that literally is what it feels like. My back is the worst affected part of me. The medications that they put you on, at one point I was on 34 tablets a day, as well as fentanyl patches. Fentanyl's a derivative of morphine, but much stronger. There are antidepressants, there are anti-sickness drugs, because nausea is a huge part of pain. So you have drugs to stop nausea, you have your muscle relaxants. It's just never ending. And it's a really, really good piece of writing, actually, written by somebody with lupus, which is similar to fibromyalgia, and they call it the spoon theory. Say you wake up and you have 10 spoons to use in a day. So having a shower and washing your hair and getting dressed, maybe take 4 of your spoons. You know, eating a meal may take 2 spoons. Walking up and down the stairs can take another 2 spoons. So then you're out of spoons, you can't do anything else. Worst things for chronic pain is to not move at all. I can't get around outside without a wheelchair. In the house, I tend to try not to use my crutches because it really affects my shoulders. So I hold on to furniture and walk around. I miss my working life, and that's another impact that a long-term chronic condition has. I was actually looking at being promoted and I lost my job. My partner is working, he's looking after the family. I just feel like it sort of robbed me of my life. It stole my life. But luckily I've got someone who's accepting me for, you know, flaws and all. I felt, once I had my diagnosis, that my life was over. Everything I read about fibromyalgia was scary. And it is scary, but it isn't a life sentence.